guys, Alex here. Today is Saturday, February 12th, just after 3:30 p.m. And the bells at the old city hall just chimed. And I'm right outside the Eaton Center here at Queen Street, just west of Yonge. And as you can see, Queen Street is closed so that the Toronto Police can protect this part of Queen along many others because of the convoy that's here for yet another second straight weekend. Well, most of it is at Queen's Park, but there's a huge police presence around here. But this is the second video I'm filming with with my brand new Panasonic Lumix digital camera. I did a walking video about like 30 minutes ago along Bloor Street East. So we're gonna see what's up around here. And I don't know, I don't have a set route in mind. I'm not sure how long. Actually, there's a recording limit for this camera. I got less than 30 minutes of recording time, so it's probably gonna be between 20 to 30 minutes of video here. Here's the Simpson Tower. Outside looks a bit ugly. Yes, that's the renovation. I haven't really been around here in a really long time, actually. I mean, I was at the mall 2 weeks ago, but I don't think I visited Nathan Phillips Square this year yet. So that's what we're gonna do here. So here is Bay Street. It is a cold, freezing day today. It's a garbage truck blocking the intersection. There's some traffic at Richmond Street. Right there, then you normally would get a good view down Bay Street, but you know, that garbage truck is blocking here. Actually, you kind of can, but not good of a view. And Bay Street is close too. It's a bit of a surreal scene here. And just to the west would be University Avenue. And I can hear the honking. That would be further south, though. I remember last summer they were doing some work on the streetcar tracks. As you guys probably know, the 501 Queen route is has partially no service, and it's being replaced by buses. I think I'll go up Bay Street or walk around the west side of the city. Well, anyway, it's a bit slushy. It's icy here now. It's been like almost 4 weeks since we had that huge blizzard. And now everything has just gone icy and the streets and sidewalks here are kind of slippery. But we'll see what's up here at Nathan Phillips. There's the Toronto sign as usual. And of course, that's where the mayor works, at Old City Hall. I'm not gonna worry about getting copyrighted by that music there. I'm not monetized. So Nathan Phillips Square opened in 1966. I know this building was used for a Star Trek scene. I think the Next Generation. But yeah. This sign is from the Cavalcator lights from the Christmas season. They should have took this down. Oh, and they covered part of the ice here with this with the floor here. It's a beautiful day otherwise. A lot of people taking pictures. I'm gonna grab one here myself because if I try to take a picture with this camera here, it's gonna stop recording. That's what happened in my last video. There we go. I think I was supposed to see a friend next weekend, hopefully. I haven't done that like since the summer. Try many times, see our friends over the break. It just doesn't work out. Hopefully next weekend. I gotta see my friends when they get back to me. Otherwise, I'm feeling good. I was kind of had a shitty week over a week and a half ago. Really love this camera so far. The quality and the sound. You know something? On my way to film my first video, got on the eastbound train in St. George, and I was able to get a view from the front. That's the second time that's happened to me this pandemic, because for almost 2 years, almost every train you get on, the driver restricts the front. And actually, I just posted that video. I was able to connect to the TDC's Wi-Fi Blur Young Station and post that to 2 minute video. There's the Henry Moore sculpture. Now you're a choppa. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Right there, can we zoom in here? It's not focusing. Okay, let me see if I could get on the tower here. Oh man. Focus. Ugh. Using the viewfinder here. Can't tell if it's good or not, but it looks good over there. Yeah, there we go. And the sun's on me, so hopefully my fingers don't freeze. Alright, been filming for 7 minutes now, so let's see if we can... Like I said, I really don't have a server in mind. Maybe we'll wind up back to Young and Dundas. Really just wanted to continue testing out with my new camera here. Then after that, I think I wanted to relax inside the bay. There's the TD Tower. Sorry, no, that's Brookfield Place. Let's test the zoom on it again. Oh yeah. That looks freaking awesome. Oh my god. Here's the Canadian flag. And right over here is Osgoode Hall. And the courthouse. University Avenue is known for its large amount of courthouses and hospitals. And university is once again closed to protect the hospitals from the convoy. And there I am. How do I look, folks? The Raptors hat, the mask on. We're gonna ditch masks very soon, I hope. Not that I'm actually against it, just we've been in this for too long, but I'm actually wearing a mask because of it's cold. But step by step, hopefully duck forward. Try to lift his restrictions. Even though he declared a state of emergency mainly because of the protests in Ottawa and in Windsor, Ontario. And here, my voice is echoing. I wanted to run because I was kind of speaking loud. Anyway, here's University Avenue. And there's a good view of the CN Tower. Here. Okay, there's like local traffic here. I don't know why, but either way, it's closed. And there's the Queen's Park Legislative Building up ahead. Zoom in here. Ah, that's excellent. And there's TDC buses blocking out the intersection of Queen and University. And University Avenue is like the only Grand Boulevard we have in the city. I really like the design of it. So what I think I'm gonna do is, I think I'll go to Dundas Street. about a turning right here on Armory Street, but that's probably going to bring me back. To check the time here, 3:41. That means I got 19 minutes and 40 seconds left of recording time. Of course, I got my iPhone SE 2 for backup. Oh, I forgot to set this to 60 frames per second. Just gonna test it out here as I'm filming. There's the event support bus blocking. No, there's two of them and two public buses blocking Dundas and University. Don't hear any honking yet. And I hear sirens. So the chaos is up ahead. But I gotta pass College Street. But I won't be going there. Enjoying all the bullshit. There's Dundas Street West, you'll find St. Patrick Station. So let's see if I can make it back to Young and Dundas in 18 minutes while I try to find some streets to navigate. Alright, let's go east here. Payphone here, obviously abandoned, not working. So this used to be the original Chinatown when Nathan Phillips Square was being built. It went to west of here, Spadina Dundas, and east of here at Girard Street. And now, since the 2010s, Japanese establishments have been popping up here, hence this is little Tokyo. There is Center Avenue. There are sickets over there. Okay, I want to cross here at Chestnut Street. Check out the former bus terminal, which closed back in July of 2021. And this used to be a major bus terminal for Greyhound, Ontario Northland, Megabus, Post Canada, and they've moved it down to the Union Station bus terminal. Right by Bay Street and Lakeshore, just south of Union Station, obviously. A good view looking west. There's Young and Dundas over there. And of course, whenever a building closes and leaves it abandoned, there's always graffiti. Well, you can't really see it anymore, but I've never been in there before. And this bus terminal was operated by the Toronto Transit Commission before I think they transferred it to the city. Oh, I love the green detail of the Sickest Hospital. I had surgery over there back in 2009 on my teeth. I was just a toddler. There's that choppa again. Is it police choppers or is it CB24? I don't know. So now I'm on Edward Street. You know something? Maybe I could take this to Yonge Street. Here's Elizabeth Street. And there's the Peter Gilligan Research Center. So the signage is still here. And yes, it's exactly looking like TTC signage, because like I said, it was operated by the TTC. And I have no idea what the hell they're gonna do to this site. There's security around here. I'm not gonna even try and trespass. Yep, it says no trespassing over there, and this area is monitored by CCTV cameras. There's nobody in that car. Look at the inside here. Anywho, and here's Bay Street again. Yeah, Bay Street has some traffic here. Look at that view down here. Oops. Oh wow. That is such a good view. Okay, what should I do? Should I keep going on Dundas, or should I duck inside the atrium on Bay? But, oh, there's probably lots of security there. Nah, I'm not gonna bring it in. If I bring my camera inside, there's probably a good chance I'm going to be accosted. Okay, I can make this later. Five, four, don't trip. Almost 20 minutes of recording time. There's the Canadian Tire on the right. And the, Ted Rogers School of Management. And, of course, the center of the universe, Yonge Dundas Square. With its small amount of billboards resembling Times Square. Scramble crossing in effect. This building here It used to be the head office for Sears Canada. Now it's just for a Cadillac Fairview. Even though there's another building, a Queen.
Where that got started.
What was the guy saying about Scarborough? Anyway, this intersection has changed a lot over the past few decades. And this is where many tourists come to take pictures and videos. And I think the Scramble Crossing is in effect once again. There we go. All right. Good view down Yonge Street. The look up, Yonge. There's a guy yelling across the street from here. Oh yeah, I'm gonna end this video very shortly. But so thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this, almost slipped there, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Definitely gonna be using this camera a lot more. Really looking forward to it. Okay, that guy's not yelling. He's a street preacher, but he doesn't have a megaphone for a change. That's actually kind of good. But check out my other videos as well, and stay tuned for more. All right, guys, stay warm and stay safe. Bye-bye.